Hey, so today we are refilling Juul pods and I'm putting on gloves because I ain't really about that nicotine rush. I just want to save the planet, man. So the first thing you want to do is to disassemble your pods and put all those in a separate container for washing later. The first part of disassembly is removing your cap. Now this can be a little tricky at first, but once you get the hang of it, it's going to be easy peasy. So I'm using a flathead screwdriver to unhinge the cap from the body. What I want to do is just to get under the black bridge thing and try to unlock it and unhinge it so the cap can be removed. So after that, I can take out the cotton pads, but we'll get into that later. So there's another way for you to do this easily, and you can use the side of the table as a leverage for removing your cap. This is especially helpful if your hands are getting tired. So by using the side of the table or the edge of the table, like, it's going to help you really take the cap off easily. And also, if you don't have like a flathead screwdriver, you can definitely use your tweezers or you can even use your fingers. So here's another close-up of what I do with a flathead screwdriver. So I literally go under the black part and then over the transparent knob to sort of unlock it. Now that you have your cap removed, you can then proceed to removing the rubber stopper from the body. So just use tweezers or your fingers, and then you can remove the cotton pads from the inside of the cap. So we're going to clean those later, so just set them aside for safekeeping. Now moving on to the inside part of the Juul pod body. So you want to unfold the metal plates very carefully. So I'm using really old tweezers, and they're pretty blunt because I don't want to like accidentally cut the metal plates. So your goal is just to unfold the metal plates as straight as you can so that when you start pushing the plates out, it'll come out in one piece since they're two separate parts of the same mechanism. So when you push it out, make sure to do it at the same time so that it doesn't accidentally destroy the coil inside. So once you've pushed the plates out, you can then grab the inside part out without destroying any of the mechanisms. And then it's time to remove the old cotton wick. So the original Juul wick doesn't look like this because I already refilled this pod. Let's review all of the steps. After removing the cap and the cotton pads, take the rubber stopper out, put it in the container we talked about, and then unfold the metal plates to make it straight, like very straight, with a blunt tweezer or whatever, and then push the plates out so that you can take the inside part in one piece. Ta-da! After that, you can then remove the cotton wick that was in there and just throw that wick away. You won't need it anymore. So this is the secret to getting no mixed tastes in your refilled Juul pod. You have to wash your Juul pods with dish soap or a mild soap, because that's really going to remove all of the debris, all of the leftover juice. These are the things that really affect the taste of the juice in your Juul and how it hits later on. So obviously, this cleaning part is completely optional. You could always use alcohol or cotton buds to clean your pods, but I don't know, it just feels safer if you wash them with liquid soap because that's really going to remove all of the bacteria and stuff without destroying the actual pod. Don't forget to clean your tools as well, like the scissors and the tweezers that you're going to use. Maybe use a UV thing if you have one, but you know, yeah. So if you notice, we didn't include the cotton pads and the coils when we were washing our Juul pods because it's better if you soak these in water separately. So clean water, soak them, and take them out after 1 minute so that they don't disintegrate. Yeah. So after soaking those, I just lay them out on my little rag or my clean rag specifically for my jewel. And then I dry those cotton pads up and I squeeze them very, very thoroughly to remove all of the excess juice and all of the water that we just put in. And I'm just using like the bottle of the salt nick that I have as a roller, but you can always use your thumb as well, and I think that's also very effective. Once you've got them all squeezed out, you can set them aside for drying. If you can, or if you have the time, you can dry them overnight so that it's really, really dry. But if not, you can use a hair dryer and force them dry. Or, I don't know, just leave them for 10 minutes, it's fine. Just as long as you don't put them in the tap when it's damp. So now just dry everything else. I'm just using a normal cotton ball and my tiny scissors for getting into those nooks and crannies inside the pod. So try as much as possible to dry them. If you can, again, overnight using a drying rack. And I'll show you like a picture. Yeah. So this is my makeshift drying rack for when I can dry them overnight. But if you're in a hurry, you can always use this cotton ball trick. And just dry everything else very thoroughly. Don't leave any water or moisture because you do not want to invite bacteria or mold. You know, just be careful. So do the same for the coils if they're still damp. And remember to dry the inside part also. So this removes the excess juice and the excess water that may have gone up inside. Now moving on to my favorite part, which is the re-wicking. So I'm using organic cotton, which is specifically designed for vapes. So don't use regular cotton balls for your vape. Okay, that's bad. So you want to cut a thin strip that's thin enough that when you roll it in between your fingers, it feels thick. Okay, that doesn't make sense, but there's no specific measurement. Just do trial and error, but your goal is just to make it thin enough that it goes through the coil, which I'm gonna show you right now. So think of it as a needle. You're just threading the cotton through the coil, and if it gets too thick, you can do this method that I'm doing, like screwing it in. And when you cut it, make sure to leave allowance on both sides and fluff it up. That's going to make your pod less leaky, so there's not spaces for the juice to come through to the bottom. It's gonna make sense. I'll just do it again and show you. So anyway, you can then fold the metal plates back down and just make it look like it was before. Remember not to push down too much. You need that slight angle for the metal plates to touch the contacts in your jewel device. So now it's time to get your juice and struggle a little bit with the childproof cap. So now we can refill the jewel pod. So when you're refilling, go down almost to the cotton and refill up until just a little under the line where the rubber stopper stops. So now you want to squeeze your jewel pod front and back to put the rubber stopper in. So this is going to make a really tight seal for your rubber stopper. So once you do that, you release and you can see all of the air bubbles coming up and to the top. So that's how you make your pod less leaky. Now all you need to do is reassemble everything, put back the cotton pads in the cap. So remember to put two, okay, just remember that. So then you could simply just put this back on the jewel pod till you hear the clicking sound. And you're basically done. So here's the most important step to avoid leaks. Get your jewel pod, put some tissue under it, blow from the top gently until there's no juice residue on the cloth, and then wipe the bottom dry. So yeah, congrats, you have refilled your jewel pod. The next thing I want to show you is how to recoil or fix broken coils, because it happens a lot and by accident. So you can see that my coil here is really like messed up. So what I want to do is to actually get a tool, maybe a stick. I have this pointy tool with me, so I use this as a guide. So what I do is I put the tool through the coil and then I basically wrap the metal around the tool as a guide to make my own little coil. So that's just so that it would look like it did before. And you want this to be tight, so make sure that after you do the coils, you tighten it, I guess. So yeah, I'm so bad at explaining, but I hope this video shows it naman. So now that you have your coil, you can then put it back on to the tube thing or its casing. So it's easier if you do this with tweezers since it's a really small part, but you'll notice that on the plate, when you slide it in, there's actually a little like notch for it, so it just goes in really quickly. You just have to find the feel for it. So once you do that, you can use the tool again to just straighten out the coil and fix the positioning. And you're basically done. You can just put the cotton rewick we did a while ago. And yeah, it's the same process. Fluff out after cutting, put it in the pod, and then push it down so that it locks or something, and then put the plates down. Yeah, so basically, just the same process. So for this one, I'm using a different juice. It's a melon mix type of salt mix. Oh yeah, and when you're using juice or when you're picking out juice, make sure it's salt mix. Okay, like don't use vape juice that isn't designed for pods. So now I'm just putting the rubber stopper again, squeeze the front and the back of the pod and see the air bubbles come up. That's when you know you made a tight seal for your rubber stopper. And once you put in the cotton pads and the cap again and click it back in, make sure you do that step where you avoid the leaks by blowing into the cap onto some tissue or cloth.
If you find the one, you should never give her up. I think it's the way life changes when in love, yeah. I surround my soul with the positivity. That's why I don't worry about the things that I don't see, yeah. These days I don't worry about much. I think we should have some more fun. I still dream about the days when we were young. I'll take a hit and still finish in one, yeah, yeah. Oh, 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 oh. Memory lane isn't that too far away. We should never let go. So tell me who you love, baby. Take a moment to unwind, fix yourself and realign yourself with the world, baby. Breathe slow, baby, yeah.